Fish.
Oh, it's a fish.
Holy mackerel. This is my first time fishing the Beaverhead. I am below the reservoir in the section that is the most popular part to fish between the reservoir and the town of Dillon. It's pretty early in the morning right now. It's in the low 40s. It's pretty cold. Yeah, it's nice water there. Water's pretty murky. Should be good. It won't. Fish can see in that pretty well. And be good because I won't spook them as easily wading around. Well, unfortunately, being on this side of the bank, it casts a huge shadow in the river. That's pretty annoying. I'll have to fish kind of upstream. Can't really fish across that much. There's a great run right up there. I'll start out the day here. I'll just be working my way upstream. It's nice there's a railroad track. It's like a walking trail in this part of the river. I got my 3-weight Sage Pulse, 10 foot. My Hardy ultralight reel. And I have a Euro nymphing line on there. It's kind of a thin diameter. And I have a Euro leader there, my standard one. It's about 11 foot long with a cider right there in the middle. And 5 foot of tippet below the cider. And I'm gonna go with the indicator at first, although I can tight line later. What I have rigged on is a yellow Sally nymph, size 10. Bead head there, a number 10 rubber legs in the bottom. This river has a really good yellow Sally hatch that comes off in June and July. And it is late May right now, but I figure there's gotta be a lot of yellow Sally nymphs in the water. Just the bottom. Yeah, it's pretty shallow. I got a bad snag here, I'm gonna get out. I thought it'd be a little deeper. Oh, a big stick. I got it by my foot. See all the insect life on there. Some pale morning duns, probably, nymphs. great spot. Hitting bottom there. Bottom again. Fish. Let's start the day. Oh, that's a fish. Holy mackerel. I thought I was on a bad snag. Tried to yank the fly out of the rocks, and all of a sudden, this fish took off. Second there, I thought it was going to be like a 4 or 5 pound fish. The way he felt. So pretty good fish. Get him to swim upstream. It's been tough to net. Very tough. I just released him. It's about a 17-inch brown trout. It's a nice girth to him. Battery went out right as I was about to land him, but literally just a few seconds after the battery went out, it came to the net. Got him on the rubber legs. It's kind of interesting how narrow the river gets. This little fast water area reminds me a lot of the East Walker. I've never seen an aquatic worm before. Fish on. I was totally looking away. I spooked him. It was a fish right there, just right on this little shelf. Yeah, he spooked. Spooked a little bit. I can still see him, just barely. Didn't think he'd be that shallow. Indicator's going right over him. Yeah, I think he saw me, so he swooped. getting back to the car now. It's amazing how much the river has cleared up. You can see the bottom now. I just think because it gets so much pressure, rivers like this, they get hammered day in, day out. We'll just have off days, you know, where the fish aren't biting. Usually that's because there's no insect activity to kind of spark their feeding. Did have a decent day though, I'm not complaining. The scenery is really surprising. I didn't think the Beaverhead was kind of surrounded by these mountains. Reminds me a lot of the East Walker. Looks very similar. It reminds me of Penn's Creek, Pennsylvania. I fished it quite a bit. Sometimes, you know, days in a row. And you'll have a day where you swear there's no fish in the creek. The very next day, there's some insect activity. And fishing's easy, you just catch them one after the other. I think brown trout will get pretty tight-lipped when they get a lot of pressure. A lot of them will feed at night. And they'll just generally kind of hunker down until you see insect activity, you know, hatch. I think this is one of the most popular rivers in Montana. There's four or five that just get tons of driftboat traffic. It's probably the Madison, Beaverhead, Big Hole. And probably Yellowstone.